knowledge.
Well, good morning. Are we ready to worship?
Yes.
For those of you who are new, these are our songbooks. There's a table next to the railing that has extra songbooks. Please help yourself to one, and we're going to start with number 76.
In ages past, our hope for years to come, our shelter from the stormy blast, and our eternal home. Under the shadow of thy throne, still may we dwell secure. Sufficient is thine arm alone, and our defense is sure. Oh God, you are our help, you are our helper to all generations. You will be forever shield and our eternal hope. Oh Lord, you are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. You are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. From the stormy blast and our eternal home. Oh God, our help in ages past, our hope for years to come. Be thou our guide while life shall last and our eternal home. Oh God, you are our help, you are our helper to all generations. You will be forever and ever our shield and our eternal hope. Oh Lord, you are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. Oh God, You are our help, you are our helper to all generations. You will be forever and ever our shield and our eternal hope. Oh Lord, you are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. You are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. Oh God, you are our help, you are our helper to all generations. You will be forever and ever our shield and our eternal hope. Oh Lord, you are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. You are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise. You are the Ancient of Days and worthy of our praise.
Good morning, Mountain View Community Church.
Good morning.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, We need to kneel down before you to praise you so that we can come together in fellowship to worship. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for giving us this day and giving us this opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Normally this would be the time in our service where we would have announcements. We would announce things like how we did at the food bank yesterday. I'm going to do that. How did we do at the food bank yesterday?
Seven.
We still served 7 people yesterday. It was more than 7 though, because a few people stepped forward after they heard about the fire and they said, give me some names. I want to take care of those people until you guys get back on your feet. Because our mission means so much to this community that they wanted to help out. And we thank them for that. Now, Alice, are you going to do Bible study this week?
Yes.
Still here at the church, right?
Still here
at the church at 7 o'clock. And we are studying 1 Kings. So if you would like to join us for that at 7 o'clock Wednesday night, we will still have Bible study. Now, if I could have my worship team come forward. Jennifer, Bill, Gail, come forward, please. Jim Schwimm, you stay back there. Now, Jim, unfortunately, all the stuff didn't come in because of, well, supply chain issues, but so I have some more coming on the way, but Jim, I got you this. It's a necklace, and on it is Luke 1:37, and what it says is faith. It does not make things easy. It makes them possible. Your unwavering faith through all of this has been amazing. And I thank you. I thank you all for helping try to make some sense of all of this. So, Alice and Jennifer, I've got you one as well. And Gail, yours is on the way. Bill, yours is as well. And same with you, Jim. It doesn't have the inscription on it. It just says faith. Tim, I didn't forget about you. This one's very special because, Tim, you are very special to Mountain View and Maricopa Pantry. And I wanted to let you know, your efforts on Monday are so greatly appreciated. You saved a lot of lives, and you did what you could. And I got you a shield with a cross on it. And on it is the inscription. It's hard to read. It's very tiny. So I'm just going to read it right here. It's Ephesians 6:16-17. And it says, in addition to all, taking up the shield of faith, with which you will be able to extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Because Tim, you definitely are a soldier for God. Time we will go into our intercessory prayer session. And normally on a Sunday we would pray, we have an entire list of people all across the nation that we pray for. Our cancer buddies, for healing, comfort and strength, and for salvation. But today I wanted to do just very simple, and I'm going to have Elder Jim and Elder Bill say a small prayer for us.
Let's go to Lord in prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, we truly humble ourselves before you this day, Lord. And Lord, we see your hand in everything that we do. Everything that has happened through this past week, we've seen your hand in it. And Lord, it has been so comforting. We do ask that you just let your spirit flow through this service and through this church body. Lord, fill us with your spirit that we might learn from you and choose the right doors to walk through from this day forward. But Lord, we ask you to be with this nation too and all the things that are happening in this world. We need a revival. We need your hand. We need you to show yourself. And Lord, as my favorite song says, and we need to remember this, that no matter where we're at or what trials we're walking through, if we look, there is Jesus. And we praise you for this. We give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's go ahead and pray again. Heavenly Father, I do thank you for being here, for interceding, to see the burned out hulks back there and the loss, and to know, to see that the building of the church appears to be absolutely unscathed, untorched, unscorched, even not even brown paint it would appear. It is incredibly humbling to stand before a sovereign God. Thank you for that. I do pray for the elders of this church as we go forward from this. Give us wisdom, give us insight, give us discretion. Help us, Father, to see not just our vision, but what you have as a path for us, so that we do indeed your will, your way. Father, I also think of this nation. I pray for the leaders, every layer of government as it goes up from the local municipality here in Maricopa to the county and state. And as we go to the nation, Father, I pray for each of them. I lift them up. The layers of authority in there, they are God-given authority. Father, I pray that you would guide their thoughts, their minds. It's probable that many of them do not know you as a personal God and Savior. And Father, we know that because you are sovereign, you can also still use them as a tool. I pray, Father, that you would guide their thoughts, their minds, their decisions, so that they do your will, do it well. Do it for the benefit of the gospel of Christ, even if they don't understand that. And I pray that you would bring into their lives those who could explain the gospel to them and present an almighty God of the universe to them, so that that revival that Jim is praying for can happen. And I pray, Father, that it would start in our hearts here today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Alice, let's listen to a song.
Let's sing a song.
We're going to go to number 60. And please, if you would like to stand up, please stand up and join me. If you'd rather sit, and that's fine too.
More of you in my life.
with all of my strength, for you are my Lord. More love, more power, more of you in my life. And I will sing your praise with all of my mind. And I will sing your praise with all of my strength. For you are my Lord. For you are my Lord.
Amen. Go ahead and be seated. I have a special I'd like to do for you. This is kind of our collective hope for ourselves, but also individual, and so I wanted to share it. It's called Carry Your Candle.
Some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites the candle, and makes his home. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, see out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your whole world. Take your candle, go light your world. Frustrated brother, see how he's tried to light his candle some other way. See your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds her candle without no flame. So carry candle, run to the darkness, seek out the lonely, the tired and worn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Take your candle, go light your world. 'Cause we are a family whose hearts are blazing. Let's raise our candles and light up the sky. Pray to the Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkness.
times. Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the helpless, deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Carry your candle, darkness, seek out the helpless, deceived and poor. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Take your candle. Oh, go light your world.
Thank you for that, Alice. Now, since I've been here at Mountain View, we've done a couple services outside, but we usually are pushed back a little bit further into the parking lot. And I wanted it set up today here so that we didn't have to look at the mess back there. And that was on purpose. I want to change your perspective. I wanted you to see Mountain View as God sees Mountain View. And God definitely sees Mountain View because He saved Mountain View. When I tell you this is an absolute miracle, because I was standing here that day and I thought there's no way that the church is going to make it. God, just save the church and save the house next door. The food bank we can rebuild. And that's exactly what God did. There isn't a single piece of this church, aside from a little bit of smell, but after a couple days of the air conditioner running with the HEPA filters and stuff in there, even it doesn't even smell that bad. And I was hoping that either the wind would change or maybe these flowers would bloom a little bit, so we wouldn't have to smell it out here, and God provided that too. So, thank God for that. But before we get too much further, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, again, we just want to thank you for providing this space and this time to come together in fellowship, to worship and praise you. Lord, we just ask that your Spirit flow throughout the day here. And Lord, give me the words to say. Let my words be your words. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I struggled with this sermon all week. I couldn't even write down notes. I don't know where God was taking me. But He led me to James chapter 1. And Lord, give it to me. Now, James is, the author of James is James, the half-brother of Jesus, which is what we believe. And I think back and I have five brothers, right? I have five brothers, and I think it would be very difficult for me if one of them was to say that they were even a preacher. I know it's pretty difficult for them to believe that I'm a preacher. I want to tell you a story back when I was, gosh, it was probably about 28 years ago. When I was young, we were cleaning the house and my mom couldn't find me anywhere. Now all my friends and family back home call me Zeke. So my mom's running around the house, "Where's Zeke? Where's Zeke?" She's looking at all my brothers, "Where's Zeke?" And they can't find Zeke. Finally, she looks behind the couch there, and there I am. So she yanks me out, and I snatched up a rosary that I had found underneath the couch. And she says, "What are you doing back there?" I said, "Mom, I was praying the rosary." So here we are, 28 years later, and I'm still holding on to that lie. And look at where I'm at now. I think my mom, well, Mom, I wasn't, that's not what I was doing back there. I was just avoiding work. You're listening. I think that James would have had a difficult time with it as well. But James is one of the authors of the Bible that seen Christ on the cross and then seen him rise again. James is also the leader of the church in Jerusalem at a time that was very, very, very troubling for Christians. And the words that he wrote in James 1 still apply today. It says, "Consider it all joy, my brethren, when you encounter various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance." That's a difficult concept to accept, isn't it? To consider joy with what happened out back. How do you consider joy? All the families that'll be without food, but we still took care of them. God still took care of them. Watching that day, it was very hard to consider joy. As the week went by and I read this passage over and over and over and over and over again, I do consider joy. Look at what God provided for us. Look at God saved. We still have a space to worship. Isn't that joyful? Also in James here, it says that God would never tempt you, but God would use these trials to better you. That's that endurance. When you go to the gym and you're trying to build muscle, right? And you're working out, it's not going to do you any good if you leave the gym early. If you don't do that last set, it's going to tear that muscle so that it can build itself back up. Now's not the time to walk away from God. Now it's time to look to God. This is testing your faith. It's not a really good story when God gives you everything. When God always says yes. That's not a good story. That's not the stories that we hear about. That's not the stories that we gain strength from. It's the times that God said no. And your faith still endured. When you're asking God questions about what's going on and stuff, rather than ask a yes or no question, why don't you ask a question he can say okay? Like, God, let your will be done. That's a question that God could say okay. And the fact that you'll be okay with that answer, and you'll still love him either way, you build up your faith. You strengthen your faith. You don't leave the gym early when you accept okay as a good enough answer. And one that you'll love him anyway. James also gives us a way to ask God. And he says, "But if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all generously without reproach, and it will be given to him." It's saying here, ask God for wisdom. Ask God, because with wisdom comes understanding, not the other way around. With wisdom comes into understanding. If you are on our church list, you'll notice at the bottom of every day that I gave you an update, I asked for you to pray for the leaders of this church and the leaders of the pantry. Pray for guidance. Pray for that wisdom. And this is why. Because that's an answer that God will give to us. He will give us wisdom. When you ask for wisdom, James says, he must ask in faith without any doubting. For the one who doubts is like the surf of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. Being a sailor, this analogy stands pretty strong with me. I've been tossed about in the sea.
You have to ask for wisdom in faith in order to receive it. You can't doubt. Like, God, I don't know if you can give me the wisdom, but man, it sure be nice. No. God, give me wisdom. God, I need wisdom right now. I need wisdom to get through these trials. God saved his house, and it's up to us to continue the mission. And God's going to provide us the wisdom to do so. Excuse me. Like I said, I don't have any notes, so I also don't have a projector to read the Bible verses for me. Every good thing given and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shifting shadow. In the exercise of his will, he brought us forth by the word of truth, so that he would be a kind of first fruits among his creatures. Friends and family of Mountain View Community Church, members of Mountain View Community Church, I would say, the gift of God was still providing us this space. And it's the most perfect gift. It is an absolute miracle, I'm sure of it, that this church is here. That day when the fire was blazing, I was standing across the road as I walked up. The wind was coming out of the south. And I grabbed the first person I could see, and we prayed for God's protection of his house and the house next door. And the wind shifted from the north to the south and saved his church. It is an absolute miracle that this church is still standing. I tell you that. It almost brings me to tears to see it. And you all bear witness to it too.
Together,
we're going to get through this. Last week, I had a church sermon about the church. And it wouldn't have mattered if that church disappeared, because the church didn't. Each and every single one of you is the church. This building isn't the church. Every one of you is the church. And it doesn't matter what denomination you are. We are the church. I thank you all for coming and supporting us. I thank you all for supporting us over the years that we did have the food bank here. And I ask you to continue supporting us, because the food bank will still be here. Always. That food bank is the mission of Mountain View Community Church. Not only is it the mission of the Mountain View Community Church, but it is the mission of the church as a whole. It is God's mission, and you all are a part of it. The first and third Sundays are communion here. And isn't it so fitting that it's the first Sunday? Can the servers please step forward and get the elements off the porch there, please? As they're passing them out, I want to make note that the cups are stacked, so be mindful of that as you pick them up, and hold on to them, and we'll all partake together. Meanwhile, well, as I said, it doesn't matter what denomination you are, we have open communion here, and what that means is, as long as you accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, and you believe in him, and you believe in the sacrifice that he made, you are welcome to join us. As they're passing it out, I want you to think about times when it was really, really tough in your life. And where if you would have just considered joy, it would have made it so much easier to handle. Think about that as they're passing it out, and reflect upon that. Think about a time, and think about this the next time trials come your way. In 1 Corinthians, we find these words from Paul. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, this is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup, also after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Come, Lord Jesus. On final note, what I want you to take away from the day is perseverance and endurance, and to consider joy. We are the body and blood of Christ, and it is up to us to continue the mission.
Let's finish up with number 180.
Rejoice, he wraps himself. at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great, how great is our God. Beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead, three in one. Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. How great is our is our God, and all will see how great, how great is our God. Name above all names, you are worthy of all praise, and my is our God, and all will see how great is our God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all how great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great, how great is our God.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May He give you joy in your troubling times and your trials. May you change your perspective and not say, look at what God did, but look at what God did. Amen.
Amen.
Okay.